Dosiahnuť niečo, čo mladý muž vo veku 27 a veľmi zriedka dosiahne. Michal Kopecký, náš druhý rečník v tejto miestnosti pre užívateľov, dosiahol za niečo cez 3 roky na svojom blogu Ako zbaliť SK viac než 1,5 milióna unikátnych návštevníkov, čo je na Slovensku pomerne naozaj obdivuhodné. Zároveň založil skupinu Učíme sa podnikať, kde sa podnikatelia podporujú navzájom a zdieľajú svoje nápady a inšpiráciu. Táto skupina má na Facebooku takmer 6800 členov. A mňa Michal zaujal ako veľmi ľudský, pokorný človek. Nie žiadny nejaký horenoc napriek jeho úspechom. A strávili sme niekoľko krásnych chvíľ a je to naozaj skvelý človek, ktorý sa má o čo podeliť. A odporúčam, robte si poznámky, pretože téma jeho prednášky vznikla pôvodne tak, že v tej skupine Učíme sa podnikať niekto dal do eteru, podielte sa o svoje stránky, o svoje blogy, o svoje e-shopy a teraz tam bolo takých zhruba 20-30 stránok, linkov, nejaké žiadosti o spätnú väzbu a Michal to zaklincoval a nakoniec povedal. Takže rozhodol som sa, že na prednáške WordCamp bude moja téma 10 hlúbých chýb, ktoré máte na vašej WordPress stránke, takže o tom vám povie. No a myslím si, že už nebudem brať čas. Potles pre Michala Kopeckého.
Tak ja vás všetkých vítam už tretím rokom, taká stalica v WordCampe. A dnes som si, ako Silvio dobre poznamenal, preto pre vás pripravil 10 hlúbych chýb, ktoré máte na vašej WordPress stránke. Chcem, aby ste to nebrali možno osobne, ale keď tam budete svoju stránku, čo sa nepredpokladá. A chcem, okrem toho teda, že som nakladateľom zložbách Slide.sk,
There are also some sister projects to WordPress. There's GlotPress, which is the tool that we use to actually make translations for WordPress. There's BuddyPress, which makes WordPress into a social network. And BBPress, which turns WordPress into a forum. These are also all open source projects, and they also need designers, users, developers, everybody to get in and help make them better. So, what's next? Contribution days. In fact, this is something that was so close to my heart after WordCamp London. I ran up to my email and declared, we're going to do a contributor day at our local user group. And Mike said, okay, fine, you can organize it. And then I started my first contributor day on my own. There's a group of 30 of us, and we just found a room in Manchester. We had a lot of
Teda vítam na mojej prednáške, som rád, že ma organizátori teda pozvali alebo že mi umožnili, aby som to dneska mohol rozprávať. Hneď na úvod som chcel povedať, že ja nie som web developer, ani sa nejak nezaberám týmto vecami, ja som online marketer, takže aj tá moja prezentácia bude viac taká užívateľská, možno nebude taká viac, nebude nejaká veľmi odborná, ale bude to skoro v takých tých možno bežných veciach, ktoré by vás nenapadli bežne. Niečo teda skrátke o mne, už teda väčšina z toho bolo povedané, že pracujem vo Visibility. My Visibility sme vlastne online marketingová agentúra. Je tu niekto, kto pozná Visibility alebo náš blog? Super, aspoň niekto. A teda, my sa teda venujeme hlavne tomu e-commerce marketingu, teda SEO, PPC, robíme aj social media a tak ďalej, tak skrátke. Teda my vo Visibility máme nejaký vlastný blog, na ktorom publikujeme články na rôzne témy. V podstate to vyšlo tak, že doteraz sme na našom blogu publikovali nejakých 458 článkov a dohromady ho publikovalo 30 autorov. Takto nejak vyzerá súčasnosti ten blog, to je už potom redesign, ktorý budem potom spomínať v tej prezentácii. Ako sa nám darilo, vlastne tak ako som rád, že ten blog funguje v roku 2009 a ako môžete vidieť, tak tá návštevnosť bola taká, že celkom v pohode, ale nebolo to nejak nič extra. Až do jedného momentu, keď sme sa my tak nejak rozhodli staviť nejakú takú radikálnu zmenu, aby sme ten náš blog a celú tú našu obsahovú stratégiu posunuli na vyššiu úroveň. A vlastne o tomto bude celá tá moja prednáška, že čo sme vlastne spravili, aký to mal efekt a čo si z toho môžete zobrať vy, ak aj vy máte nejaký blog. A v podstate sa nám podarilo dostať nejakých 2500 zobrazení mesačných, niekedy december 2013 na 27000 zobrazení v marci 2015, čo bolo v podstate nedávno a čo bolo taký nejaký náš vrchol. On to možno nezdá, že to je nejaké brutálne číslo, či je to ľudia, ktorí by
after party vyššiu návštevu. No? Come on, who's going to the after party? Bit more than that, hopefully. So, just to introduce who I am. So, he's already, Silvio's already said quite a couple things. I heard you made other products, everything, so I guess you have a small background about me. I'm originally from Switzerland, Zurich, so I'm not too far away from here. I run Human Made with my two partners, Tom and Joe. We have 24 employees now or so, which is pretty fun. We are completely remote, so that's the beauty of today's technology, right? You can work from anywhere in the world. We have people in Norway, Australia, the UK. I'm everywhere in the world because I don't really live anywhere, so that's my joy. We're also a WordPress.com VIP partner. We're the only ones in Europe, which is pretty cool. So we get to work on pretty large clients, Airbnb, Skype, PayPal, Samsung, all these sort of larger things, which really pushes WordPress to its limit, right? So we really do a lot of WordPress stuff, even if we consider ourselves a technology company. One of our more prominent projects recently was Belong Anywhere from Airbnb, where you know there was the celebration, the anniversary of the fall of the Berlin Wall. It was great to be able to create a multilingual website, even if it was a small project for Airbnb, and even if 90 people worked on this one page for a couple of weeks. It was really cool. So, apart from the agency stuff that we do, we also have quite a bit of products and things that we build ourselves. I run the product unit, so in this case we have Happy Tables, for one. Happy Tables is a platform whereby restaurants can create and manage their own websites. I'll show you a short demo in a bit. And then we also have WP Remote, which maybe some of you already use to manage multiple WordPress websites at the same time. So,
that's good because I didn't want to fall in love to begin with. Like, I guess everyone that does is good. All right. Well, I hope you all had a very, very good day. Nice WordCamp. I want to say thank you to the organizers for putting up with me. And like change the schedule for me and everything. I'm here to talk to you about some of my experiences of remote working. let me introduce myself. My name is Petia. I work for HumanMade, which is one of the top WordPress agencies in the world. I have the honor to work alongside some amazing people. I'm also a WordPress contributor, even though I don't code at all. I contribute to the WordPress Polyglots team, which means that I help people translate WordPress into their languages, and I also help organize events, just like these wonderful people here. I am one of the organizers of WordCamp Europe. So, I want to start today by asking you a question. By the show of hands, if you were asked, what would you do if you had more spare time? How many of you would say travel? All right, awesome. Yeah, I'd say travel too, you know? So, people get asked that a lot, and most of the people that would answer travel. There's kind of research that proves that. And a lot of people spend their life working hard and providing for their families and taking care of their kids, raising their kids, and traveling is left for like holidays and the moment when you can